In this video, I'm going to go through the steps for how to process a return. So from the point of sale menu here at the top, I'm going to select New Return Receipt, or from the Make a Sale screen, I'm going to click the Accept Return button. Either one of those two options will display this box where you'll enter or scan the original receipt information in. So I'm just going to select a receipt from the list because I don't have a barcode scanner attached. That's going to pull up the items that were initially purchased by that customer on this transaction. And I'm going to say that my customer is returning the computer case, so I'm just going to check the box in the return column and then click the Add Selected Items button. Now it's important to note that you want to follow the either accept return or point of sale new return receipt steps because, for instance, this computer case has gone up in price since this customer initially purchased that item. So if I were to not enter that initial purchase information in, then I might end up refunding my customer more than they actually paid for that item, because as you can see, it's now gone up to $125.99. So you definitely want to enter in that initial receipt information first. Now, point of sale is going to default that you owe your customer cash for their return. You would, of course, want to refund your customer in line with whatever your store's return policy is. If you don't have a return policy, then I'd highly recommend that you go ahead and establish one. I'm just going to click Save Only here to close out this return transaction.